Hello, darkness, my old friend. I've come to talk with you again.
Right, now, where was I? Ah, yes, so... Right, so... This chair, I need to get a new one. So, I entered the 1950s, where it was, like, well, from there on, the invention of rock and roll happened. So, it was all sex and blood and rock and roll. I remember that much in the 50s. 50s, though, it was like rock and roll. So, I remember 50s, there was the, you know, superhero comic books and that, you know, Batman, Superman, Captain America, that I was selling, and some sweets as well to some human kids. And I remember rock and roll being invented. It's nothing like what it is today, but, you know, back then, Elvis Presley, Bill Haley, and just some good tunes, really, playing, and they were very enjoyable stuff. Yeah. And then, of course, there was the coronation of Queen Elizabeth II. I remember that too. I'd, you know, purchased a television set. Cost me quite a couple of bob, but I remember the invention of the TV. God, it were amazing. I remember watching it and thinking, it's as if they're in the room with you. It was that fascinating. I couldn't believe it. You know, a small box with things you might have seen in the showroom, the cinema, were right there in the living room. So anyway, I remember, you know, watching the live broadcast of the Queen's coronation. It was a crazy day. Crazy. I didn't really go outside in the daytime, but I still watched it with the curtains closed long before I got this ring. And I just remember, you know, watching it happen. And I, you know, looking at it now, I thought, oh, another monarch. But knowing that that woman was going to become the longest reigning monarch since time began, succeeding Queen Victoria. Yeah. Mental. And then I could hear the street parties happening outside. When the night came in, I, you know, went out and mingled, and yeah, everyone was celebrating a new queen. She already became the queen a year before in 1952, but for some reason, a coronation got delayed until, like, I don't know, 1953. But still, it was happening. Churchill was Prime Minister again back then. You know, he'd won the Conservative election and what have you. I remember the Queen and Prince Philip's wedding. What, you know, listening to that on the radio. I didn't really watch it, did I? Because, you know, tellies were just starting and they weren't nothing like they are today. So anyway, yeah, I remember the Queen's coronation. And what else do I remember doing? The rain is pouring outside. Sorry about that. So what else do I remember? Well, I remember, you know, like I say, the 50s. Something had started up in America called McDonald's. Never knew that it'd become a big fast food selling chain around the world. I mean, back in the 50s, McDonald's didn't come to America, to Britain, until 1974. But I did actually go to America once during that time. But not to forget, I had a business to run. I had a comic book store I'd opened. I was running that. So the 50s were pretty basic, you know, 50s, junk food not known to be unhealthy by then, and, well, I think they knew it were, but, yeah, the rocking 50s. And then came the 60s. Oh, the 60s were peaceful times, you know, yeah, I'll never forget the 60s. There was one program that started in 1963 called Doctor Who. We'll get to that in a moment, but 1960, you know, I remember that. In fact, I actually went to Vegas in 1960. Yeah, I managed to save up for a holiday there and went to Las Vegas. I remember seeing the Rat Pack there, 1960. They're also like that film Ocean's 11 as well. Yeah, I remember that film. I remember the lights in Las Vegas. God, all them casinos. Like the mistake capital of the world. I remember, you know, seeing the Rat Pack perform, and I remember seeing Elvis perform. I even, like, hypnotised the, you know, the backstage security so I could get in and actually see them. And I was mingling with Sammy Davis Jr. and Dean Martin. Frank Sinatra, he was alright. I, like, chatted with him for a bit, but all the ladies were all over him, and, also, I wasn't the only vampire there. There were a couple of other vampires there. We, you know, after that, we all like decided to go off and get something to eat, grab a bite before the sun comes up and stuff. So yeah, we had sex as well. Me and these vampires. Hadn't made a new clan or but at that point. Anyway, after 4 weeks of Las Vegas, you know, gambling and just going mental and seeing, you know, big performers and what have you, I just then went back to England and resumed my regular comic book life. Lived in a small house back then. Didn't really pay much bills because, well, I didn't need to pay for heating or gas. Or electricity. I was a creature of the night. I mean, I did pay for electricity, but I never really used it much. I used it to turn the lights on and listen to the radio, but I never really paid any gas bills because I'm immune to the cold. And I slept under the floorboards. See, that's the thing with vampires, you know, sleeping in coffins, that's an old thing. I mean, yeah, there are still vampires out there that do sleep in coffins. Some sleep in freezers or fridges. I like to sleep under the floorboards. It's right nice and comfortable under there. I have slept in beds before, but, you know, I do prefer the, you know, the nice, quiet, drafty floorboards. Anyway, 1961, 1962. I remember the Russians developing space travel. Turns out that when the war was lost by the Nazis, a lot of America and Russia took a lot of their science projects and use them to develop space travel, which had never been done before. The only thing that did space travel back then were aliens, you know, non-humans. Do aliens exist? Let's just say Earth is not the only planet with life. It's such a big universe out there, and the humans, they're really just learning how to walk, how to, you know, travel in space and what have you, and discover stuff. But still, they know more about what's out there in space than they do on the moon, so they are, you know, developing fast. But yeah, have I ever encountered an alien? Once or twice in my long life, I had a close encounter of the first kind, which was seeing a UFO in 1750, and another one in 1889, yeah. That was a close encounter of the first kind. First kind is seeing UFOs. Second is Second is making contact, I think. Third kind is seeing the aliens. Fourth kind's abduction. The fifth kind is keeping contact with them. I've only ever had close encounters of the first kind twice, and the third time back in 1971, which I'll get to in a moment. But yeah, aliens. Anyhow, throughout my life, I've come across many things, werewolves and witches and warlocks, many other supernatural creatures. So anyway, 1962 happened, and then we got to 1963, and that started, it was Doctor Who. Yeah, Doctor Who started, and Yeah. I never knew that show would still be running to this very day. It's insane. Heard they're considering a woman to play the Doctor next. That'd be interesting. Very interesting. But it's 2017. Yeah. And then, of course, there was another band that came out, the Stones. The old Rolling Stones, the Beatles. Beatlemania was a thing back in the days, you know. Girls couldn't get enough of them. The term teenagers had finally been used for the first time ever. And then, I remember, the Stones obviously getting stoned a lot. I hung around with a lot of punk rockers back then. Even saw the Stones live as well in concert. Managed to hypnotise my way in there. I was with another vampire woman that I had a date with, and we partied, even managed to go backstage. Met the Beatles! Yeah. But you should never really meet your heroes. I met them and my date, she, had a vision because she was one of them vampires. A virgin that could predict the future and see stuff. She like said that two of you were gonna outlive the other two. And one of you, will be, let's just say, after that I completely, fell out with them, the Beatles. I mean, John Lennon, I really looked up to that man, and just after meeting him, it's just, you should never meet your heroes. I felt sorry for Ringo, though. It's like they never took any of his songs seriously, but they did do the album Yellow Submarine eventually. And then came, 1966. England won the World Cup, which was a big thing. I was actually in London at the time when that was happening. I didn't go and see the match live, but I remember in the pubs everyone were going nuts that night because it was in the afternoon daytime, and I remember it. And in England actually hosted the World Cup back then as well. England winning, it was insane. They even made it to a final in 1970, but they lost. But still, they haven't made it to a final since, and they've not won, since 1970, and they've not won the World Cup since 1966. But will they win again? Possibly. There's always 2018 Russia. And then there was the first ever regeneration in Doctor Who. That was a big, deal, because it's like, wow, our lead actor's changed and he's still the same character. It was insane. It went until the end of John Pertwee's run, they used the term regeneration. Anyway, the end of the 60s came, 1969, and history was made again by the first man walking on the moon, Neil Armstrong. See, I spent a lot of this time in Europe. I only went to like America once at that time. Went to see the Rat Pack and went to Vegas and what have you. I was talking about going to New York. Anyway, the moon landing. People say it was faked, directed by that Stanley Kubrick, but was it? Still, it's made history though. The first man on the moon. I read that book as well from H.G. Wells, The First Men in the Moon. I'm thinking, did H.G. predict the future? Did he know something we didn't? So yeah, that was the 60s. Now let me tell you about the 70s.